What's up guys, Sal here. So if you've been following the tech news recently, then you know that Samsung is ending the Galaxy Note line and replacing it with the Galaxy Z Fold line. Yes, it isn't official yet, but all the sources say the same thing. Plus, the fact that there's absolutely no development of the Galaxy Note 21 indicates that unlike previous years, the rumors are actually true. The Z Fold will take the spot from the Galaxy Note as Samsung's best offering for that particular year. Now we have more information about the Galaxy Z Fold 3, which shows that in the absence of its biggest rivals, Apple and Huawei in the foldable market, Samsung is planning to bring some groundbreaking technologies to the Z Fold 3. Samsung's engineers really outdid themselves with the improvements on the Z Fold 2, which honestly looks light years ahead of the original Fold despite being only a year apart. And that's what we'll see on the Z Fold 3 as well. We've heard rumors a couple of months ago that Samsung is bringing the Underdisplay camera technology on the Z Fold 3, making it the first Samsung phone to have this technology. But since then, we haven't heard anything about it until now. South Korean media is reporting that Samsung has started the production of Underdisplay cameras for the Z Fold 3. Samsung's own LSI division, which supplies camera sensors for their flagships, will make these Underdisplay cameras. Samsung has also developed a sophisticated image correction algorithm to improve image output. Also, to improve the light input on the camera sensor, they're making a special type of display in which the area above the front camera has many tiny holes which we can't see through our eyes, but they will allow more light to pass through onto that camera sensor. Since Samsung has already started producing these camera sensors, it's a very good indication that the Z Fold 3 will indeed be the first Samsung phone to get this technology. Also, the Z Fold 3 will have the S Pen support, and to make sure it doesn't dent the display, Samsung is increasing the thickness of the ultra-thin glass by twofold from 30 micrometers to 60 micrometers. By the way, Z Fold 3 isn't the only foldable Samsung is launching next year. There will be three foldables next year to be exact. The Z Flip 3 will be launched first in spring, followed by the Z Fold 3 and an affordable Z Fold FE or Z Fold Lite. We don't know anything about the Z Fold FE except that it's going to be affordable. Now, don't expect it to be $700 affordable, but somewhere in the range of $1,000 to $1,200, which is good for foldables. The price will further come down once more people start buying foldable phones. Anyway, there's one more foldable phone Samsung is working on, and it's called Galaxy Z Fold S or Z Fold Scroll, which is actually a rollable smartphone like the one we saw a couple of days ago in an Oppo device. But don't expect it to be launched next year, as Ice Universe says that the rollable phones are far from being mass-produced. They're still a concept phone and are going to remain a concept phone even next year. The foldable phones will take the spotlight and the Z Fold 3 will lead the technology. Interestingly, LG has already teased a rolling display phone rumored to be called LG Slide and is expected to be launched in March next year. And like Oppo, I don't think LG will showcase it as a concept phone, but rather try to sell it to consumers just like the LG Wing. In any case, I'll keep you updated with everything. Let me know what you think about this down in the comments. And as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.